In Manitoba, the Family Property Act sets out the rules for dividing the value of family property between spouses or common law partners, whether heterosexual or same-sex. In the case of common law partners, the Act applies to those who have either registered their relationship with the Vital Statistics Agency or who have lived together for at least 3 years. What assets are covered under the Act?
Typically, I think you can assume that any property that you've acquired during the course of your relationship is going to be shareable property under the Family Property Act. There are some significant exemptions from that, but they're generally narrowed to three types of property. One is inheritances. The second would be gifts from third parties to one person in the relationship. And the third exception would be pre-acquired property.
How do we determine the value of the assets?
When we're valuing an asset, the Act specifically says that it's fair market value. So for a vast majority of our personal items, such as contents of the family home, essentially what you're looking at is the value that you can get for the items on Kijiji. What's particularly important, though, is defining the date of valuation. And the date of valuation is a date that we use for the purpose of determining the value of family property that is akin to taking a snapshot of your family property at a certain date. The date of valuation is the date of separation. Jointly held assets, joint bank accounts, a home that's held in joint title, are not included under the Family Property Act. If the home is in one person's name, we look at the value of the home as of the date of separation or the date of valuation. If the house is jointly held, then we look at the value at the time when the house is dealt with.
Once all the family property has been evaluated, and that includes pensions, businesses, and property outside Manitoba or even outside Canada, the division takes place.
We take one party's assets and we take a list of all their assets, take into account their inherent tax liabilities, and that gives you a figure A. Then you subtract their liabilities, so any liabilities that might be in the individual's personal name, credit cards, loans, those types of things, so that we have a net for the individual that on their balance sheet. For the other party, we do the same thing, take a look at their assets minus their liabilities, come up with another net. So we have A plus B is essentially the family property. You're each entitled to half of that family property.
Evaluating and dividing family property can be a complicated process and one where legal advice can be indispensable.